Bloop bloop everyone, welcome back to Loop Hero. We will play another one. And that will be awesome, I think. We have to build some buildings though. We couldn't even upgrade now for some reason. I don't have enough of these things, whatever those are. It's fine, it's fine. Just build some buildings. Now, this one is very important. Gymnasium, a place where you learn how to read, write, and be polite to your teacher. Physical training takes priority. Unlocks the ability to gain special traits after killing monsters and expeditions. We get EXP for that now. Unlocks the village card, which is a very important card, which we can combine, as I mentioned before, with the vampire mansion. And it will a village will heal you for 35 HP or something. If you put a vampire mansion next to it or in its vicinity, then it will be ransacked. And four ghouls will spawn three times. And after three loops, the village will prosper. And you will be healed in there for 135 HP. There is one other thing with the village. You get a quest. And if you kill the quest monster, you get special rewards. And these special rewards are not bound to your... Well, let's say to the rogue with the refuge. We can unlock the rogue class with the refuge now. And the rogue has a special thing that he gets trophies for kills and only gets equipment for those trophies at the end of the loop. So, quests are a way to get around that. Quest stuff you get instantly if you did the quest before. So that's interesting stuff. We have the Herbalist's Heart Potion. The hands of the Herbalist always remember how to mix dried herbs and brew healing potions. Potion heal heals 4% of max HP. You can take up to 3 potions with you. 2 potions are refilled at the camp. Unlocks the Swamp Card. Swamp Card is really bad. It's really bad. I would like to try it though, but not with this character, but with the Rogue. A smithy, there's always work for a blacksmith, apocalypse or not. Lets you start an expedition with basic warrior's gear, that is very nice. Unlocks the ability to craft tools for the camp if the supply depot is built. I actually would like the gymnasium and the smithy now. Those would be my priorities. If we can build them. The gymnasium is a no-brainer, we need this one. This is so important. And I will just put it there. So that's how it works. Instead of remembering something, you can just learn it again. That's a nice trick. There's no ill intent. Without education, our world would be left to the savages. You too could learn a few things, though. We could all get together and share our useful knowledge and skills. Nah, I already know all I need to. Yeah, right. Leave learning to the kids. Your first lesson, learn to like learning. That would make life easier for both of us. Yeah, indeed, it would. Now, we can do the smithy. We need 2 wood, 4 stones, 7 of the metals, that's good, and 2 rations. We can do the herbalist hut too. That is nice. And if we do both, we still will have enough left to do this one next time. If we just get 3 more stable metals and a bit more wood, which wood is easy. The metals are not that easy sometimes, but we will get the smithy. Oh, we could get another thing. We could get the cemetery, which is nice. A gloomy but necessary part of every village. Passing through the cemetery on expeditions grants you a memory fragment. Can resurrect the hero after an upgrade. That is cool. Just a nice resurrection. The supply depot is interesting. The appraiser will be happy to identify all the strange things you find on the road and pass them on to the people who need them most. Unlocks the supply feature. From now on, you will begin to find useful artifacts for your people. Interesting. Unlocks the ability to craft items if you have the necessary buildings. Unlocks the ruins card, which I don't know yet. That is nice. But we will drop the smithy in here. Let's just put it, I don't know. Let's just put it here, I guess. Let's just put it there, it's fine. By the anvil of the seven seas, it's a small forge. Yo ho ho, you have no idea how I've missed the heat of a furnace and the smell of metal. We'll have some good tools now. You can be sure of it, lad. You'll even be able to use something during those trips of yours. You're quite enthusiastic. Something tells me you're not a stranger to seamanship. Shiver me hammers. How did you know? It doesn't matter, though. You're right, don't worry. I'll prove to you that these hands can hold a hammer as good as they can hold a helm in a storm, and for a dozen days in a row if needed. Great. Now we have a smith. That's perfect. Let's build something else. Yeah, I think the herbalist hut. Let's look at the smelter, though. In addition to the forge, makes a blacksmith lives a bit better, so your life will become better, too. Unlocks the Storm Temple card, unlocks the Arsenal Golden card if the Intel Center is built, and plus 30 base HP. Interesting. Let's put the herbalist hut somewhere, I think. Don't know if there's... Wait a second, I need to look at something. The field kitchen. Yeah, the refugee camp needs to be attached to that is the problem. I know that, luckily. So this is the field kitchen, so the refugee card must be here. Let's just put this one in here, I guess? I don't know. Let's just put it in there and let's see.
It's a miracle that we could find some fertile soil. And that we were able to save some seeds of precious healing herbs.
But the real miracle is that all these healing poultices and balms still haven't any effect.
We've already lost many people because of the cataclysm. It would be nice not to lose more to disease. And these potions can also help you take a bottle or two on your trip and your chances of getting back unharmed will be much higher.
Yes, we get potions now, which is nice. And I don't think we... Yeah, we don't have stuff. We don't have more stuff to build something. I would like to get into chapter 2, but the problem is I don't think we can survive yet. Does it has an effect to build the gatherer next to the kitchen farm? I don't think so. But I don't know, actually. But I don't think so. As you can see, the chapter 2, the enemies have more abilities, the strength gets 5% higher in the beginning, and they get 3% per loop. And I get more bonus resources, and I can take more resources with me, which is nice, but I don't think we can do it. It's really, really bad. I don't know. We can take new cards, though. I want the village card. I don't want the swamp yet. Because spawns a mosquito every 3 days, all healing effects are lethal here. Except for the potions, they are still on your side. The problem is, we have a regen ability with a warrior. Not with a rogue. With a rogue, I would take the swamp. With a warrior, I don't. Because if I have regen built to keep my HP up, I would just lose HP every second, and that sucks. I don't want that. I still think we need the treasury. Or it could help us. Do we want to drop a card, though? We want those two. The village heals 15 plus 5 times loop HP. Okay. Upon entering. Okay, it increases with every loop. So 5 times loop. In loop 1, it heals 20. In the second loop, it heals 25 and so on. It always goes up by 5 with every loop. And gives us a quest, which is interesting. Rock and Mountain. Oh, they are both in. Okay. It's one card. Interesting. I don't know. Do I want to drop something like the battlefield or something? No, the battlefield here is nice. I would drop this and exchange it for the swamp with the rogue, because the rogue cannot get anything from a chest. And these things are good for chests. Good for chests only. No, I think we will take this. We will take this like that. It's fine. I still think we should do the first loop again. Shall we try the second and see that we will die instantly, or shall we try the first one again? Because we can just kill the boss again. It's fine. Should we try the second one? You say the first one, Cosmodan? Anyone else has an opinion? The problem is these abilities are really bad. The strength gets up there really, really fast. And our problem is that we don't have the... Well, we do have the gear, so maybe we start with warrior's gear. Although we start with warrior's gear with the rogue too, which is ridiculously dumb because we cannot use rings and we get a ring. That's... no, and we get a shield, I think. We get a sword, a shield, and armor. That's the warrior's gear. And the rogue cannot put on shield, so... That's stupid, but okay. Don't know why. I know why he cannot put on shields, because he can do dual wielding, but I don't know why the warrior's gear doesn't include a double weapon drop for the rogue. We only have the warrior at the moment. So, shall we try the second one? Let's just try it, come on. Who cares? I need to prove to you that it's bad. So, let's just do that. We have gear, and that's good, because we need the damage output in the beginning. The second boss is interesting, because I know something about this boss. We will need to have damage to all, at least a little bit, to fight the boss. Because the boss is bad. In that way. If you don't have that, you are... it's almost impossible to do the boss, I think. Let's just build our peak somewhere. We could put in a grove. Like here. Get a blood grove in here. I mean, I guess. Could put a vampire mansion in here. Yeah, let's just do that. That's fine. I want some vampires. I want to kill them. Murderize some vampires. We could put a village in here and get healed somewhere. We could also ransack the village. Or instantly. I think so. I don't know if we get quests then, but who cares? I want to ransack village. Okay, it's not ransacked. Oh, maybe just next to it gets ransacked. Okay. Yeah, well, then we put another one in there. We got a quest. We cannot see what the quest is. No, this is the quest. There. The little crown up there. This thing will have 200% HP, and if we kill it, we have done the quest, and if we reach the village again, we get a reward. That's fine. Well, the attack speed is nice. But there's less defense done. I don't like that the defense doesn't get add up. In the is it equal or is it higher or lower calculation. Oh, and we will take the healing potion automatically. I think when we lose more than 4% HP. I think he just takes the potion. Let me drop the rocks this time. Because I want the peak ASAP. Don't want to put the mountain in for that, but, well. The mountain is useless, I think, if you do not have... Yeah, if there's nothing adjacent to it, so one mountain doesn't give you anything. There's another village, let's try to ransack this one, yes. And there's a bandit camp. Every two villages or so, it will spawn... Yeah, appears for every two village tiles. Spawns a bandit on an adjacent tile every 2 days. Bandits prefer villages, so there will be a bandit in here, but this is a ransacked village now. The farmers couldn't fight off a hungry vampire. They could still fight you off, though. Spawns up to 4 ghouls once per loop. Transforms into something useful after 3 loops, as I said. And it's a prospering village after that. I could use the Oblivion to get rid of the bandits camp, because bandits suck, so I will do that, I think. The flavor text is cool. Yeah, I like the flavor text. And the flavor text gives you hints on what will happen if you combine tiles. I don't know all of it. Not even slightly yet. There's a ring. That's nice. I like that you can drop stuff in while in combat. And that you can read stuff. Oh, we are bleeding. Okay. That you can just hover over stuff and the game won't progress. It's really nice. This is the quest, Slime. 200% HP quest goal. Corrosive structure. Each attack lowers target's defense by 6.6 points until the end of battle. Yeah, they have abilities now, and that sucks. Everyone has at least one ability. Evasion of Vampirism. Should we sacrifice defense for that? Maybe. Oh, 4 ghouls, look at that, how they dance. Aren't they nice? We got the quest reward, though. Oh, and the vampire, of course. Attack speed, regen, evasion. Yeah, that's perfect, actually, for this fight. I want the evasion. Oh, we have a battlefield. I could use that, and I could get another ransacked village if I want. I may want that. Ghouls drop stuff, that's nice. Carrion Eater. Devours a random corpse destroying 25% of each of its HP, yeah. And there's vampirism because of freaking vampire. He just devoured the corpse and lived a little longer. I guess I will put the lantern in here and ransack this village too. That could be fine. Just ransack the crap out of this one. And we will have two villages that heal us for a lot. For a lot. Another grove. Another oblivion. And I want a battlefield in here, I think. I don't think the boss gets anything from surrounding tiles this time, but I'm not sure. So I will try to fill the tiles around our camp. It's probably not a bad idea. Yeah, there's a swarm of bats. They are vampires, they are swarm, repel and squeak. Everyone who doesn't have this ability gets the ringing in the ears effect, which has a 10% chance of interrupting attacks, and it has vampirism because of vampire. The vampire stupidly spawned them. Bloody pets summons bats after health drops below 50%. He spawned them and he has ringing in the ears too, so yeah, he's a moron. And it just lets us miss every 10% of our hits. Which is fine, I guess. Now I get a little more. A little more HP, that's fine. Dandy. I want to place the meadows. Because I don't get healed every day at the moment. Don't know where, though. I mean, I could place them here for the moment. I guess it's fine. Just activate them. Should get healed now, because we pass our camp. A cemetery. Let's try one here. Let's get another grove. Red wolves aren't amazing, but they are fine. The skeletons are better, because we get more from a loop. More regen. The damage drops, though. Damage to all is nice, though. That's fine. Let's just take this one. My god, the damage he just puts out with the stupid bleed effect. 20% chance to cause bleeding that deals 12 damage after every attack for the next 3 seconds. Wow. Okay, boosts his own damage with that. That's amazing. Cool ability. I want that ability too. Oh, and don't forget, we get XP for each kill, so watch closely up in here. Let's just put the meadow in here. We can just put the meadows in here too. I like the music. It's really, really nice ensemble. The Game Boy music, as Kasmodan put it. Magic damage, vampirism. We could get more vampirism, that would be fine. Just heal a little more. But actually, I want damage. Just give me damage. If I can kill everything with two hits, it would be a nice thing. 6-bit for the win, yeah. Is it 6? Isn't it 8-bit? 8-bit music? I really like the music for the next boss. Oh, we got our stats. Or one stat, actually. We just got one trait. We always get to choose from 3 traits. And I see one that is really nice in here. The first one is Surveyor plus 0.5 times loop HP for an adjacent roadside tile while passing a tile. So that means if we are standing on a road and there's a tile, adjacent, like a vampire mansion, then we get 0.5 our loop and in HP. So at the moment we would get 1.5 HP if we pass a tile that has anything next to it. So that's nice, but not much HP. Article of Protection. After receiving this effect and after every loop, the hero receives a bar of Phantom Protection that equals 65% of his max HP. All damage to it is dealt ignoring defense. That is a nice one to increase survivability, and we could just regen per second while we have this phantom HP and get some leeway, get some relief. It's nice. And there's Blissful Ignorance. Deals you a full hand of Oblivion cards. We would just scrap our whole hand. From now on, using Oblivion cards heals the hero by 10% of his max HP. That is a nice one. Just a little early. I think we will get the Article of Protection. And I didn't want to drop my whole hand at the moment. Yeah, they will damage us. They will damage us without caring for our defenses, but I think that's fine, actually. Yeah, now I want to get rid of you, because you suck. Don't want goblins. Goddamn gobos. The shield is nice. It's a lot of defense. I like the evasion, though, and the vampirism. Well, I need damage. Don't want this ring. Pure defense is good. Let's just take this one. And there we get a better weapon. Nice. Counter. Unfortunately no regen, but okay. It is fine. Because now we can regen while we have this phantom stuff thingy. Thingamabob. After every loop, the hero. Oh, yeah, okay. Only after every loop. So we have to complete the loop, which later won't be good. I think it's good that we have taken this now. Because as the game progresses, the effectiveness of that thing will decline. Decrease. Now let's get some meadows in here. And finish the peak. Got another chrono crystal though. Could put that one here, that wouldn't be good. Here it would be better. Because I can get the meadows in here. Another grove? Do we want another? Maybe not here. But maybe here. Because I could get a blood grove in here and a lantern in here. Let's just get another one here. Let's compromise on 7. 7 bit. That's not how it works, Kasmodan. That's not how it works. Great, we got a treasury. Yeah, I will put you here. We got another one. I will put you here, I think. And start surrounding you with meadows. Actually, that's not the best one. If I surround them with stones first and then meadows in the corners, I can get one meadow in. That will be instantly activated. One more. Could get another chrono crystal in, but I don't think that's potent. Magical damage, defense, and attack speed. Not worth it. Polearm sucks. Yeah, no, it's fine. Not the best equipment. Skellies didn't give us much. And there's the village. What did we get? Good stuff. More regen. Yeah, I like the regen at the moment. Damage and vampirism? Nope. Not at all. But there you can see. 3 loops have passed. Count's lands. The village is thriving under vampire's protection and its inhabitants are very generous. Heals 95 HP upon entering. It's probably the same calculation, just with more base. Gives you a quest with a better reward. So it's good that we ransack this village. The harpy just flew in. The great thing with the rogue is not only can he crit, which we can't, but he has 2 weapons, so he gets double the damage, which is amazing. So amazing. A road lantern, I think we'll put this one here. A blood grove, put it here. That's it. Still need better loot. Way better loot. Don't just put it over because it's the same, just wait for it to drop. We need more much stable metal for our stuffs. Another cemetery, I think I will want... I want one in here. I could ransack another village down here, which would be fine. Because I don't want all my healing up in here. I want some healing at the end of the loop too. And maybe some more in the beginning of the loop. So if you can get that, that would be amazing. Don't forget that we need to have an Oblivion ready to get rid of the bandit camp. Although we should at least experience the bandits once, so next time I won't just drop it. There's another blood grove. There's another shield that sucks. And a longsword that sucks. The regen would be nice though. It's not that much damage that we lose. And I want the regen because we have HP to exploit, so... Got a quest, we got healed, perfect, there's the quest thing. We can get another blood growth in here, do I want one? I don't know, we can get one in here. It's just one over, one down. I need to put a blood growth here. Maybe we can wait for that, because I want it on the boss this time. We beat the boss last time without the blood growth. With the blood growth, it would have been way easier because, well, we would have had felt we would have felt the effect too. There's another village. We can ransack that too, and I think I will, because it loop 7, and we can reach loop 7. We will have 3 of those. It's perfect. Just one here. A rock. Put the rock here. Will I use the blood growth? I don't really know. I want another growth. Come on. Give me a growth. Game, be nice. Be nice to me. You're not nice. Okay. I think it will be the last time we take the treasuries with us. Next time we won't. Because I want the other cards to drop. Oh, this time, as you could see, there was a beatdown skeleton or something. I don't know the description at the moment. We will look at this next time. Oh, what stuff can you do? Foresight gets the prediction effect every 3 seconds, which allows it to ignore incoming damage once. Oh, that's bad. Every 3 seconds, it can ignore damage. That is really bad, because instant evade. My god, I want this ability. We would need damage to all, then we could counter. No, we couldn't counter that effect, really. No, we couldn't. Oh, I got another growth. Great. This time we can have it in our campfire. Doesn't actually matter where we put it. If you put it here, both of those growths will be affected. No. No, they won't. I would put the blood growth in here. At the end of the loop or at the beginning of the loop? Let's say at the beginning, just because. Because we are healed. But now the effect will be on our camp too. And that's fine. That is a strong ability indeed. Really strong. It's an instant evade, a sure evade that you cannot overcome unless you attack. I don't actually know how to counter that properly. You would need double attacks. That would be fine. Then the evade wouldn't count as much. I want to drop the cemetery really, really much. Oh, I hate that. Did you have to kill the Empire first? Was that necessary, really? Stupid little bats. Although our HP is fine, they cannot do enough damage to us. Oh, we got another XP point. Nice, another trait. Another of those. Yeah, let's put you here. So we get limited by the lantern already. Which is fine. I could put you in here and double up on those. That is great, I think. And another one would be great here. Let's just put more meadows in. This one will be activated shortly. Could put you in too. That's great. Actually amazing. Yes. Double up on that. And I like that the game is that chill. Really do. Second thoughts. Get a new set of 3 traits. Doesn't spend points. Battering Ram, the hero rushes into battle head on. And his first attack has a 70% chance to stun each enemy for 1 second. That is awesome. But only the first attack. A tank, yeah. Great for the boss, I guess. But only once. I could get another set of 3 traits. If I don't like those. Or I take the Blissful Ignorance. Which is great to just heal up. But I still think it's too early. I think we take 3 more. Strong aftertaste. 1.5 damage for every potion used. That is great. That is really great. That's just instant damage. Shieldmaster, 10% chance upon hit of stunning target for 1 second. That is better than the other one, than the Battering Ram, because this can happen with every hit. And 1 second stuns are great. Dominant Mass, damage is increased by 20% of defense value. That is also great. Also, 20% is just 4 damage. At the moment. Not even exactly 4. So I like all of them. Which is the best though? What would you say, guys? Shields. Stunning. 10% chance. Which is not much, but it is there. Or damage. I think those two would be nice. Because I don't know if it's retroactively happening. But we already used potions. We'll probably use some more. And we get 2 with every loop, so this will just increase. You'd go for the stun. Any other opinions? Yes, no, maybe. Okay, let's go with the stun. Let's just try it. Let's see how good it is. Although the potion thing is better in the beginning if it isn't retroactively. Maybe. I would have tended to the potions, but it's absolutely fine. More regen? I don't think we need the regen at the moment. Which is a nice situation for us. Yeah, we'll even drop the regen there. Just for more damage. Ah, it's a mimic. Great. And it has ambush now. Creature's first strike is always a critical hit, 200% damage, and always hits the target. Yeah, you little shit. The mountain peak should be in here. Let's just activate this one. We have a really good armor. With regen, evasion, and vampirism. Yeah, that's just good. The regen drops, though. But more HP. More HP is more HP in this instance. Less defense, but vampirism? Nah. The rogue has innate vampirism, by the way, but cannot gain more, I think. Which is strange. He has 5% and that's it. But it's something, I guess. Yeah, just damage. Just damage, damage, damage. And there's our quest target and with a lot of HP. My goodness. And the bleeding sucks so hard. And I think... No, the 15% is still working in here. And it's eaten. We got a battlefield, another one. I don't want to... I really don't want to overlap them. Well, the blood clots weren't that bad, were they? I don't think they were. Let's just get a blood path and a blood path and spawn one blood clot, just to say. And of course, more of these of the chests, which are amazing. They were fine without abilities. Oh, another village. Nice. We can just get a heal in here, for example. Or in here. They still could get a vampire mansion in there. But some healing is nice. And there... Is there another bandit camp? Yes, of course. Of course there's another bandit camp. You suckers. Need another lantern. Or another oblivion. To get rid of that. I don't like the chrono crystals much. I mean, it's just 3 HP more per day. That's not much. A day is long. There is a trait, though, that can decrease the time it takes for another day to take place. So we can actually manipulate time, which is interesting. Yeah, we'll take this one now. A lot of healing and a lot of quests. Many, many quests. I like quests. That's not nice. Our magic damage went down by a lot. Just murderized the dumb harpy. I guess there? No, here. Because I want the meadow here for the chrono crystal and then it's activated automatically. Could get a chrono crystal down there. Oh, there's a goblin camp too now. Well, I guess we have to deal with that. Don't want it in this. Yeah, perfect. I could get... Yeah, a chrono crystal there would be fine, I think. Another grove. Another grove. We could put a grove in here. Just double thingy. I don't think it's important, though. Let's just get the chrono crystal in here. So we can get more of those effects. I mean, the effect is nice. Just 6 HP in, at the start of each day makes it worth a lot more, but... It's not even quite as useful as the regen per second. Let's say a day is 60 seconds. If you have one regen per second, you already got... almost as much HP. Just permanently regening. We need the damage to all. And more regen is nice. The evasion stays the same. I think this ring is better. I really favor the regen and the evasion. And the next boss, evasion will still help, so. The axe is worse, oh boy, really. Oh boy. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Regen is nice, damage to all is nice. Magic damage is nice. Yep, better ring, in my opinion. Yeah, there we got blocked. And again blocked. By this damn screeching. The screeching little sheets. Soon this Ransack village will be up to snuff with the other ones, but I don't think we will ransack the last village. We could, but I don't think we should, because I don't think we will manage to defeat those ghouls before the boss. I mean, we could try. The combat takes a long time, though, because we won't... It will always be 4 ghouls there. We won't be fast enough through the loop. We will have to wait, because we need to put it next to it. So I need an oblivion. But we could do that. Should we? What would you say, guys? Guys and gals. peoples. Gamerids, gammies. I like gammies. Another meadow. I want a stone in here. We need more stones. Don't get enough. You can see with 12 cards how hard it is to get what you want. So it's probably better, like in most cases, to in most games with deck building capabilities. To get rid of some. Oh, there are a lot of bandits there. To get rid of some cards and just have the ones you really want in your deck. I could limit this. Yeah, let's just limit this first. Hope I get another lantern soon. The Phantom HP are nice. Although they're not holding up for long. What do I hit? This one? Submerge goes underground after every 2 strikes. Cannot be targeted. Oh, great. Awesome. But we attack it again afterwards. Yeah, but the blood clot sucks now. That ability really, really is bad. One of them needs to be a stone. Not both, though. So just one more stone and we have this one completely... completely dried out. And then just 2 more and this one will be done. Then 4 more and this one will be done. And then just... I could use stones in here, that would be fine, I think. And just use all the meadows after those things in here. No, already! There doesn't need to be any more meadows in here. Okay. Now, the ring, no. No, okay. First time we see a bandit. Hey, I don't remember you. You don't look like a local. That's because I'm not. I see, and you think you can just wander these parts without consequences? Times are rough, you know, nothing to bite, nothing to wet one's whistle, and we have to deal with strangers who have no sympathy for our poverty. What? You think you're better than us? No. Did I guess right? Is this the correct answer? Because I'm getting the impression this is one of those cases where the answer has zero influence on what happens next. Yeah, exactly. I like the dialogues, they're awesome. Well, you've got insight, and it's the only thing you will keep today. Oops. What abilities do you have? Brigand, 5% chance to destroy heroes' item when attacking. Yo, that's not cool. Come on. I really need to get rid of those bastards. I really need to get rid of this camp. Come to think of it, murderers and thieves are part of this world too. If my mission is to return everything back to normal, should I be happy they're appearing again? On the other hand, being disgusted with murder and theft is also part of this world, so I guess I don't owe it to anyone to be happy. Kill the camp. Yeah, I will. As soon as I get an Oblivion. I hope I get the Oblivion trade thing again. I will take it this time. Gladly. Still, we should keep a damage to all item. We don't need much damage. Just one would be enough. But we need damage to all if we want to be able to fight the boss. And we actually do, right? My god, you stupid harpy. It's ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. Again, we get too much damage. We need to get more lanterns to control the enemy horde. There's 8 damage to all item. Very nice, another village. Defense, attack speed, evasion. I would like the evasion. Evasion, vampirism. No, I need the regen in here. Else I would have taken this one. Another village. I think here would be fine after this horde. I have to watch it though. I don't want more bandit camps. And another flash golem. Dying strike. Won't die until it deals its last hit. I hate that ability. That can really screw you. And it does 78 damage.
80 damage.
Yeah, now it only dies after the last hit he deals. So it deals. This one is good. Gave us good stuff, but still, another blood growth. Do I want one? I don't think so. I mean, I could blood growth this thing. It would be nice. I guess. And if I oblivion this, this will be a hungry growth. And damage me too. Do I really want that? I don't know. I don't think so. I could get the effect here though. Yeah, that's fine. Another meadow. No, I don't want the meadow there. I want the meadow here. You could villa that village up. I could. I just don't think it would be worth it. And I'm already almost dead, which is bad. Defense, damage to all. Yeah, the defense is important. Oh, big regen. Big regen. We need the regen. Because I'm almost dead. I need to hit those two villages now. I really need to hit them now. Oh, God. Yeah, I know I'm entangled. God damn it. Entangled is really bad. No, I don't want this here. I could use this one, though. Let's just use the mountain. No, the mountain is bad. I don't want to use the mountain. It doesn't give me anything if I put it there. Unless I put another mountain in here. I don't think hitting these villages with vampires would be good, because we need to do three loops after that. And we won't get to loop 9. If we get to loop 9, we're dead. Long before. So I don't think that's prudent. Little healing. It's nice. Oh, another quest target. Bad, bad, bad. Look at the HP. It's a mini boss. It's good if it's a slime, because slimes still die like crazy. But damage to all. Ooh, that's good. Less, no evasion then. Oh no, that's not good. Oh my god, the 30%. 30%. The 30 damage. It's ridiculous. I just do too much damage. Too much. It's too much. I need more stones. I want to plunder those things. And another one that just does too much damage. I got entangled again. And I think that's a free hit for an enemy. Problem is, we need to get back on our HP game. We got a nice ring. It's not good at all. My god, all the enemies. Look at that. And those hit so often. 1.1 attacks per second. This one only has half of that. Yeah, now because an ally died, they do more damage. Which is amazing because I don't have any HP. I need to get rid of both of those. I need to get rid of the camp and I need to get rid of those. This one is good though. Although it is less damage, it should be better. I think. Oh god, so many of those. Those are little goblins? And this is a goblin leader, okay. Tactician increases the attack speed of all. Great. Please kill them. Please kill them. I think that could be the end. I hate goblins. Yeah, I'm dead. Yep, dead. Sad. And as I said, you need two skulls for this level. So I cannot get all the other stuff with me. Which is sad, we would have needed this. Couldn't do anything. Goblins, man. You really need to get rid of them. I'm alive? But how? Thanks to us, a small group of us dragged you here. It wasn't easy. Yeah, I can imagine. How could you fight off all those monsters? They nearly killed me. That's also interesting. Many of them vanished right before our eyes. Some we managed to avoid, but I think most of the beasts were gone even before we left the camp. I think your trips are deeply connected to your memories, my friend. Everything falls apart as soon as you're unconscious. Well, that's good, I guess. We could build something. A farm. Yeah, I wanted to build the refuge, though. Farmer's crops are always a welcome sight on the dinner table. All empty tiles around the farm are transformed into gardens. After an expedition, it gives you one ration for every completed loop, but not more than there are garden tiles around the farm. You can build something over the garden. Unlocks the ability to craft food if the supply depot is built. Unlocks the wheat fields card. Wheat fields are interesting. We should build it here, because then most... that this will be the most surrounding tiles. Unfortunately, there isn't a better one. No. There's always this thing in the way. Well, that's fine, I guess. Let's just build it, because we can. And there it is. Have you noticed how strangely this oblivion affects our senses? Hunger, for example. You can't stop eating for days, and you still won't be hungry. This, of course, does not mean that you should stop eating altogether. The farmer promises that he'll be able to grow some stable crops, but it will take some time. It will be interesting to see what he can grow without sunlight. Indeed. Now, it was a good try in the second chapter. We could go back there, or we could do one more of the first run. Let's just see. The wheat fields. Haystacks look like a cozy place to rest, but you have to move on. Can only be placed next to a village. Plus 5 times loop HP to healing in adjacent villages. Spawns a scarecrow every 4 days. So it's interesting. I may want to... I mean, the battlefield gives chests, which is nice. I may want to get rid of the treasury and get the wheat fields. I may also want to get rid of chrono crystals, because I don't think they're worth it. They're nice. But all they do, let's just do the math. You can have maximum 4 meadows around them. These 4 meadows, if activated, give 3 HP, which means 12 HP, doubled, 24 HP per day. Is it really worth it? And I can maybe place 3 or 4 of those, so... Well, that's 100 HP. More or less. Don't think that's really worth it. Scarecrow, I'm in favor of that. Yeah, right. Don't think that's worth it. And I would like to get less cards in my deck. Just to get the cards I want more often. And I think wheat fields and villages combined would be interesting. Because the healing gets increased, which is nice. Still like the cemetery, though. I don't think I would drop more cards. But probably the treasury. I don't know. The treasuries are nice, and they give you a lot. But the other cards are nice, too, and they would probably let me live longer. Maybe. And how many treasuries I get? 3 or 4. I mean, I could still put them in. Don't know what this means, though. I need at least one of those cards in my deck, it seems. I need 2 of those, so there's... I cannot get rid of them. Yeah, I need to have 2. I need to have at least 2 of those cards, up to 6. So I could get all of them in. I cannot, because I only have 12. that I can bring with me. And I have two of those cards. Okay. I need to have two. So I could get rid of the cemetery and the grove and the blood grove, and that would be fine. I don't think I want that. I mean, you can really specialize your thingies. I mean, you can get Vampire Village, Vampire Mansion Village, and Wheat Fields like crazy with this build. You just get rid of all the other crap. And I mean, groves are not that great. The Blood Grove is interesting, and you can only place it adjacent to groves, and you can use it to kill the boss quicker. But that's it. The loot you get isn't that great. If you can just put villages everywhere that heal you every tile, it's amazing. The bandits are crap, though. The bandits are so bad. We really have to look out for more oblivions. I didn't get any oblivions last time. I think two in the beginning, and that's it. I don't know if these bubbles up there are any indication of how often you get this crap. It would be interesting to know, but I don't have any idea yet. Didn't you want to get rid of the treasuries? Yes, but no. They give a lot of stuff. And it's so easy to get the stuff. Just surround them with rocks and meadows and you're fine. And they don't take the chrono crystals with me anyway, so... The swamp is so bad. Spawns a mosquito and healing effects get reversed. It's not good for the warrior. It's okay for the rogue, I guess. Because the rogue doesn't have anything like that. If you hit a day, you're screwed, but still. I would try them with the rogue, not with this class. I don't know. Should we get rid of the treasuries? Let's just try it. Just one card less in our deck should be fine. I will put a cut in here. I guess we do another loop and try to reach the boss this time. I hope you watch again for Loop Hero, and I will see you there.